Well, new at 11 tonight, every year it seems the valley heats up even more. Las Vegas is the fastest warming city in the country, according to new research.
And 13 Action News anchor Carla Wade now shows you why we have had a temperature increase of more than 5 degrees since 1970.
We wanted to know what this information about climate change means for our city and for you on an individual level. So we came here to the National Weather Service to ask one of the experts.
So just a significant amount of development over what was previously desert floor.
Lead meteorologist for the National Weather Service in Las Vegas, Chris Outler, shows us these graphics. The green represents land surfaces that are pavement or rooftops. Starting in 1972, what used to be vast desert steadily becomes covered in concrete. Urban sprawl and a population that has exploded in recent years are all factors contributing to Las Vegas's dubious distinction as the fastest warming city in the U.S. That's according to Climate Central, an organization of scientists and journalists studying temperature trends.
What's really remarkable is that we haven't had a record low temperature in Las Vegas at McCarran Airport since June 4th of 1999.
And what that means is while we expect very warm days in the desert, especially in the summer, we aren't getting as much of the expected cool down at night.
No record low temperatures have been set since the year 2000, but we've had many, probably over 100 record high temperatures set.
And that has real human consequences for heat sensitive people like the elderly, children, and the homeless.
You know, you can't argue with the numbers. Our climate has changed, whether it be from urbanization or from other larger scale factors, and that's something that everybody needs to be prepared for.
They have jurisdiction over planning.
The Southern Nevada Regional Planning Coalition has that job.
I think Clark County, the cities, all have plans in order to make sure that we're doing our part to address climate issues.
Jones pointed to the example of some airlines not being able to take off from McCarran when it's too hot, which impacts tourism.
I think that it's important for the LVCVA, the Airport Authority, and all of the organizations to take a look at how they are going to be affected if our temperature continues to rise.
Carla Wade, 13 Action News.